Saint Flotini was a woman from Samaria who people typically looked down on. At this time, no one even knew her name. Jews were known to hate Samaritans at this time because of their beliefs. Not only that, but no man would talk to Flotini because she was a woman and because of her history with men. She had been married 5 times and lived with a man she was not married to. However, Christ was unlike any other man. As Jesus was passing through the town, he stopped at a well known as Jacob's Well to rest. Flotini came to the well to draw water when Jesus asked her, "Will you give me a drink?" Flotini was confused because Jews never talked to Samaritan women and because Jesus had nothing to draw the water with. Jesus explains that if you ask God for a drink, he will give you living water. And this water is unlike any other, because whoever drinks the living water will never thirst and have eternal life. When Flotini asks how to get this water, Jesus tells her to go get her husband. Flotini says that she has no husband, but Jesus did not judge her for this. Instead, he treated her like the beloved child of God she is. Flotini sees the love in Jesus and goes into town to tell everyone about her encounter with the Messiah. Flotini told the people, "He told me everything I ever did," and that led the other Samaritans to believe in Christ. Jesus stayed in Samaria for 2 days teaching. As other Samaritans heard Jesus' teachings, they learned that he was truly the Christ. After this encounter with Christ, Flotini and her whole family were baptized. At baptism, she was given the name of Flotini, which means enlightened one. Flotini continued to travel as a missionary, spreading the word of God. However, when the emperor of Rome, Nero, began to persecute Christians, Christ appeared to Flotini in a dream, telling her to sail to Rome. Flotini, along with other Christians, including her 5 sisters, all went to Rome to talk with the emperor. Before the soldiers even had a chance to arrest her, she was already on her way to Nero. Showing no fear, Flotini told the emperor that she has come to teach him to believe in God. When the emperor asked if they were willing to die for Christ, they all answered yes. Hearing this, Nero ordered their hands to be beaten with iron, but Flotini and her sisters felt nothing. Nero continuously tried to get the women to renounce their faith, but nothing worked.
In fact, Flotini ended up converting Nero's own daughter to the faith. When Nero heard of this, he tried to kill the woman with fire. For 7 days the fire burned, but the woman remained unharmed. Nero continued to torture Flotini and her sisters, but they all survived. They were all held in a Roman prison for 3 years, and in those years, Flotini transformed it into a house of God, converting and baptizing many inmates. Finally, Nero had all Flotini's sisters and sons beheaded, leaving her all alone. Grieving the loss of her family, Flotini finally gave her soul into the hands of God.